Pakistani court commutes death sentence of key accused in American journalist killing. In news from Pakistan, a Pakistani court on Thursday commuted the death sentences of the main person accused in the 2002 kidnapping and murder of American journalist Daniel Pearl and acquitted three other co-accused in the matter.
Pakistan's Sindh High Court on Thursday commuted the death sentences of the main person accused in the 2002 kidnapping and murder of Wall Street Journal reporter Daniel Pearl and acquitted three other co-accused in the matter. In the year 2002, an anti-terrorism court had sentenced to death British-born Ahmed Omar Syed Sheikh and life term to the other three for the kidnapping and killing of 38-year-old Pearl, who was researching a story on religious extremists in Pakistan's Karachi. While arguing the case, the lawyers for the appellants said the prosecution had miserably failed to prove its case and prosecution witnesses were mostly policemen. The court commuted death sentence of Sheikh to 7 years in prison, while the other three convicts, Fahad Naseem, Salman Saqib and Sheikh Adil, who were earlier handed life sentences, were set free by the court. Since prime accused Sheikh has been in prison for the past 18 years, his 7-year sentence will be counted from the time served.
Top US diplomat for South Asia, Alice Wells, has condemned a Pakistani court's overturning of a death sentence handed down over the 2002 gruesome killing of American journalist Daniel Pearl. She called the decision an affront.
The United States has criticized a Pakistani court's overturning of a death sentence handed down over the 2002 gruesome killing of American journalist Daniel Pearl, calling the decision an affront. The Sindh High Court in Pakistan's Karachi city on Thursday commuted the death sentence of Ahmed Omar Syed Sheikh, the main person accused of kidnapping and murdering Pearl, a Wall Street Journal reporter investigating Islamist militants after the September 11 attacks. Top U.S. diplomat for South Asia, Alice Wells, said on Twitter that the overturning of the convictions for Daniel Pearl's murder is an affront to victims of terrorism everywhere. She said those responsible for Daniel's heinous kidnapping and murder must face the full measure of justice. The court ruled Sheikh's role in the murder wasn't proven and gave him 7 years for the kidnapping. Since he has already spent 18 years in jail awaiting the outcome of an appeal, he is likely to walk free in the coming days. The court also acquitted three co-accused.
Moving on, doctors in Pakistan-administered Kashmir held a protest recently demanding testing kits and safety gear to deal with coronavirus patients in the illegally occupied region. They blamed Pakistan for a stepmotherly treatment while highlighting the absence of medical facilities in case of a crisis.
The Young Doctors Association or YDA recently held a protest against the Pakistani government demanding safety kits for healthcare staff dealing with suspected coronavirus patients in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. They also raised concerns over no testing kits, mask shortage, no ventilation support and lack of proper isolation wards. They claimed the government has completely failed to provide these basic requirements in the illegally occupied region to deal with the crisis. The protesters also voiced their concern about their salaries, which they said are not at par with doctors in other parts of Pakistan.
Pehli demand corona ke khilaf kits, dusri demand hamari tanhaein, hamare marad Punjab aur federal ke mutabik masavi kiye jaye, ki barabar kiye jaye. Sirf isi surat mein YDA apna kaam continue rakh sakti hai.
The protesting doctors warned that they will be forced to launch a complete strike and withdraw from their elective services if their demands are not met immediately.
आप क्यों एहतजाज कर रहे हो? ये आवाम को जानना ये बात जरूरी है कि स्टेप 1 से लेके जहां पे आपकी कोरोना वायरस की स्क्रीनिंग है, आपके पास यहां पे स्क्रीनिंग किट ही नहीं है, टेस्ट ही नहीं है. तो आपके पास पेशेंट आता है, आप उसको बस क्लिनिकल सस्पिशन पर डायग्नोस करते हो और ज्यादातर कोई रिजेक्ट करे. हुकूमत आवाम को ये धोखा देना चाह रही है कि आपके पास कोई पेशेंट बर्डन ही नहीं है, लेकिन कोरोना वायरस.
Absence of medical facilities has remained a matter of grave concern since long in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. The doctors blame stepmotherly treatment to the illegally occupied region by Islamabad as the primary.
More news from Pakistan. The number of coronavirus cases climbed to over 2,250 in Pakistan on Thursday, while 32 people have died so far. As lockdown is imposed in most parts of the country, Pakistanis have expressed concerns over inflation at the time of such crisis.
The number of coronavirus cases in Pakistan climbed to over 2,250 on Thursday. So far, 32 people have died from the disease since the first COVID-19 death in country was reported on March 18th. Most parts of Pakistan continue to be under lockdown despite Prime Minister Imran Khan's opposition to it, claiming that the country was too poor to sustain a lockdown or curfew. The government has been urging people to not visit mosques for prayers, a tradition in Muslim majority country, and instead pray at homes.
کہ حکومت پاکستان جو اقدامات کر رہی ہے وہ انسان کی بھلائی کے لیے کر رہی ہے انسان کے اچھے کے لیے کر رہی ہے تو لہذا میں تو اس کے بارے میں یہ کہوں گا کہ یہ ٹھیک ہے اس سے کیا ہے کہ انسانوں میں جب دوریاں ہوگی اور آپس میں جو دوریاں پھیلے گی ہوگی تو اس سے ہم بچیں گے کیونکہ کورونا سے ہم بچیں گے تو پاکستان جو صحت مند ہوگا
While some are welcoming the prevention measures by authorities, some also expressed concerns over the rising inflation during lockdown under the rule of cash-strapped Imran Khan government.
مہنگائی کر رہی ہے غریب آدمی کہاں جائے گا روز کا کھانے کمانے والا دس دن سے بازار بند ہے آپ یہ دیکھیں دودھ مہنگا آٹا مہنگا ہوا ہوا ہے چینی یہ کھانے پینے کی اشیاء کم کریں اس سے کیا فائدہ اب فائدہ کیا ہے پیٹرول سستا کرنے کا اب تو پہلے کے بیٹ ڈاؤن ہوا ہوا ہے گاڑیاں نہیں چل رہی ہیں
Pakistanis have lately been under a tough squeeze on their household budgets with the highest inflation in the January over a decade.
Human picture has emerged from India's neighbor Pakistan, where a systematic exercise has kept the poor away from receiving essentials. The organizations involved in the distribution are not giving Hindus and Christians the food sanctioned for them.
کرونا وائرس کی وجہ سے ہم گھروں میں بیٹھ گئے ہیں ہمیں کوئی راشن واشن ملتا نہیں ہے اور باہر جاتے ہیں تو پولیس ڈنڈے مارتی ہے اور گھر میں بھگاتی ہے تو ہم گھر میں بیٹھ کے بھی کیا بھوک مرے ہمارے چھوٹے چھوٹے بچے ہیں تو ہم کہاں سے کھائیں ہمیں تو کچھ ملتا ہی نہیں ہے اور مہربانی کریں
اچھا یہ جو باہر جو این جی اوز والے یا دیگر جو راشن دے رہے ہیں وہ کیا ہندو برادری کو دے رہے ہیں
ہندو برادری کو کچھ بھی نہیں دیتے ہیں ہم جاتے ہیں تو کہتے ہیں آپ کے لیے نہیں ہے وہاں ان کے آتے ہیں جتنے بھی تو ان لوگوں کو دیتے ہیں ہمیں کچھ بھی نہیں دیتے ہمیں بھگا دیتے ہیں وہ لوگ
Activists have called it a systematic design of suppressing the minorities. They say that these instructions are coming straight from Islamabad and Pakistan is exploiting the crisis against the minorities.
ڈسکریمنیشن یہ ہے کہ وہ راشن جو ہے وہ ہندوؤں اور کرسچنز اور جینز اور پارسیوں کو نہیں دیا جا رہا تو وہ جب پوچھتے ہیں کہ بھئی ہمارا راشن ہمیں کیوں نہیں دے رہے تو وہ کہتے ہیں یہ آپ کے لیے نہیں ہے آپ کے لیے علیحدہ سے ٹرک جو ہے آپ کے نیبرہڈ میں پہنچا دیا جائے گا آپ کے علاقے میں پہنچا دیا جائے گا لیکن ایسا کوئی ٹرک وہاں پہ آج تک تو پہنچا نہیں ہے اور ان کو باہر بھی نہیں نکلنے دیتے باہر نکلتے ہیں تو پولیس ان پہ تشدد کرتی ہے لہٰذا لوگوں کے گھروں میں اس وقت جو ہندو فیملیز ہیں اور کرسچن فیملیز ہیں ان کے گھروں میں اس وقت کھانے کے لیے کچھ نہیں
پاکستان ہیز شٹ آل مارکیٹس پبلک پلیسز اینڈ از ڈسکریجنگ لارج گیدرنگز امیڈ دا کرونا وائرس پینڈیمک رینڈرنگ ڈیلی ویج ورکرز جاب لیس The government announced it would be disbursing 12,000 rupees to low-income earners as part of a $940 million economic stimulus package. Social distancing has been thrown to the wind in Pakistan as authorities struggle to enforce it, especially among the country's poor, as many head out to purchase food in fear of the coronavirus spreading and a curfew being imposed.